So good morning one and all. So today we'll start our class. In the last class we have started with the third chapter. In the third chapter we are discussing about general or continuous type of a random variable. Now for this type of random variable we have a PDF. PDF means probability density function. What is notation? Notation is fx of x. Right, next. Now, so by using PDF we can find the probability of the occurrence of the given random variable. How? So to get probability you just find out the area under the PDF. You find out the area under the PDF, that is nothing but your desired probability. Yeah, so this is a very important point to be remembered. That is, so excluding or including the endpoints has no effect on the probability. Yeah, so if the probability is between A and B to be calculated, that is probability that x greater than A minus probability that x greater than B. You know this? No. So these are the some of the attributes of a valid PDF. It should be always non-negative. And the second property is called normalization property, which is very, very important, which is the entire area under the graph of PDF must be equal to 1, or it simply says the total probability should be equal to 1, obviously. Now this is the graphical interpretation of the continuous random variable. So here we are finding the area under this graph from A to B, which means we are getting a probability of random variable x from where to where. A less than x less than B. Suppose it is B to C. If you find out this area, what does this indicate? Probability that it is between B and C, B less than or equal to X less than or equal to C. If you find the entire area, obviously you are referring to what? Total probability that equal to 1. Now this is a simple problem we have solved yesterday. You got C equal to how much? 1. Actually what is this? If you draw this, it is 0 to 1, it is 1. What it is called? It is called PDF of uniform random variable. Here A equal to 0, B equal to 1. If you remember these things, it would be very easy. Now this is another example. So here we are checking whether this is the valid PDF or not. It is valid PDF because it satisfies basic property, that is normalization property. Yeah, so this is the another problem we have solved. Yeah, so this is the uniform random variable and this is how it is defined. Here what is C? You got, you found out C equal to 1 by B minus A. C equal to much? 1 by B minus A. Now this is the graph of the PDF of the uniform random variable. So it is not that clear, but this is A, this is B, this is 1 by B minus A. Why it's called uniform? Because it is same for all values of between A and B. It is uniform. What is the value? That is, what is this value? 1 by B minus A. Now this is another type of random variable. So that is called exponential random variable. Now how it is defined? lambda into e power minus lambda x when x is greater than or equal to 0, 0 otherwise. What is lambda? So that is a positive parameter of this type of random variable. Now we have proved this. In the last class we have seen whether this is a legitimate PDF or not. It is a legitimate PDF. We have proved this also. This is very, very important. So these are the graphs of the PDF of the exponential random variable for small value of lambda and large value of lambda. Now, so I told you yesterday, it is common for both discrete and continuous type of random variables to have a CDF. CDF is common for both, but if it is discrete, it will have PMF, probability mass function. If it is continuous, it will have PDF, probability density function. But CDF is common for both type of random variables. And its notation also common. What is the notation? Capital Fx of x. And this is the basic definition of the CDF, that is cumulative distribution function. Now this is the final definition of CDF of a continuous random variable. Yeah, obviously this is the typical meaning of a CDF. Yeah, this is the relation between, what relation? Relation between whom? P, D, F and CDF. What is CDF? Integration of PDF. What is PDF? Differentiation of CDF, obviously. Reverse. Now this is a table which illustrates the relation between PDF and CDF of a discrete as well as continuous type of random variable. If x is discrete, okay, what is CDF? That is summation of PDF. Not PDF, we call PMM, sorry. Isn't it? Now what is PMF? Obviously, that is the difference of CDF. What difference? First difference. You are taking the difference between fx of k and fx of k minus 1. Something like taking the difference between x of n minus x of n minus 1. Present value minus previous value. In the same way, present CDF minus previous CDF. It is called difference, first difference. Now, so this is for continuous case. What is CDF? Integration of PDF. Obviously, what is the PDF? Differentiation of CDF. Okay. Now, so simply, in simple terms, we can write like this. So, here I can write like this. CDF equal to summation of PMF or CDF equal to integration of PDF. Okay, this is one case. What another case? PMF is first difference of CDF. PDF equal to differentiation of CDF. Okay, just remember like that. I told you the analogy of S and S in the last class. Okay, that is very much sufficient. Next. Now let us study some of the properties of a CDF. This is the definition of a CDF. Okay. Yeah, it has a continuously varying form. Okay, it varies something like this continuously. Yeah, it is monotonically non-decreasing function. So what it is exactly, I will explain a little bit later, but it is non-decreasing function. I am not saying increasing function. What I am saying is it is non-decreasing function. Okay, I'll explain this point later. Yeah, so for continuous random variable, CDF has no jumps. Why? Because it is continuous. Why I am saying like this means, in the last classes, in the last unit, we had discussed CDF of a discrete random variable, which is nothing but a staircase structure. It has got discontinuities. Okay? But here, the CDF of a continuous random variable has no jumps. It is a continuous in nature. It has got no discontinuities. It is continuous always. Okay. Now the main properties are, it is continuous and it is non-decreasing function and it is varying continuously. Okay. So now this is the typical PDF and CDF graphs of a continuous random variable. Now, so what is this? What is this PDF of what random variable? Uniform random variable. Why? Because it is A to B and with the height of the this rectangle is 1 by B minus A. Okay. Now, so let us solve this problem. How to find out CDF if you know PDF? Okay. What we do? We do integration, isn't it? Okay, right. First of all, so here we are finding the CDF of uniform random variable. Uniform random variable. Okay. Before proceeding further, so let me recall the PDF of a uniform random variable. That equal to, what is that? 1 by b minus a, if it is between a to b, 0 otherwise. So the graph is, no need to draw a graph again, anyway, let me draw this here. This is the PDF of a uniform random variable. So this is something like this, a to b. What is this value? 1 over b minus a. Okay. Now, we have to find out what is the CDF of this graph from the PDF. Now, this is given thing, given value, given thing is, this is PDF. Okay. Now, so we know already the relation is, what is the relation? So, fx of x equal to integration minus infinity to x fx of t dt, isn't it? Now this is the CDF, this is the PDF. Now what is fx of t? So let us draw this. So please, here I am changing the variable to t. Here the variable is, I am assuming t. This is t, not x now. This is a. Here we are constant, so they won't change. 1 over b minus a. Now this is the our PDF. Now we have to do integration, but so please remember, it is not simply integration, we have to take care of limits also. Why? Because suppose if I ask you what is the integration of this PDF, okay, what generally students do is they take this area, complete area. How much you get? How much area? So this is b minus a, this is 1 by b minus, you will get 1. They say that the CDF of this random variable is 1. But you are not finding CDF, you are finding the total area. Obviously that will be equal to 1. What is that is called? That is called as normalization property. Here we are not finding the entire area of the PDF. We are finding the integration of PDF. But that is not the entire area of the PDF. Okay. Suppose here what happens here is T. Okay. Suppose if I ask you, if T is less than A, case 1, otherwise let us take simple scenario where T is less than A, what will happen? When T is less than A, what is there here? Nothing is there. Okay. Then what happens? What is the integration of this fx of T dt? That will be 0, because when T is less than A, the function is 0. Nothing is there. Isn't it? Right? Now. Here, second case. Let us take, we have some variable, let us take T equal to X, but X lies between A and B. Okay, means what? So here, we have some point X here. Okay, where is X? It is between A and B. Now find out the area or integration. Now, so we are finding from where to where now? From where to where now? A to X. Actually, what is this? It is minus infinity to X. But what happens here? The function is non-zero from A to B only. That's why I'm starting from A, I'll go up to X. I am assuming that X is here. Okay. Yeah, so here it is not starting from minus infinity, it starts from A up to X. Now, so what is the value of this? That is 1 by B minus, that is constant, it does not change. 1 by B minus A dt. Then what do you get? So let me write here again. So here we are finding this from where to where? A to X, 1 by B minus A dt equal to what now? Find out T by B minus A, but where T varies from where to where? A to X, which means X minus A by B minus A. X minus A by B minus A. Okay, what is this here? I am assuming the point of integration. Up to what value we are finding? X. X is between A and B. If X is here, suppose, if X is less than A, obviously, answer would be 0. If X is between A and B, now this is answer. Suppose if X is here, somewhere here, what is your answer? What is the answer? That would be equal to 1. Okay, why? See, it is very simple. Suppose X is here, find the area of the curve here. There is no curve at all, area would be 0. Now X is here, find this area. What is this area? So this is AX, X minus A by B minus A. Suppose X is here, find the entire area. Obviously, entire area means 1. Okay? 1 if X is more than B. Now, so let us draw the, let me write this here. Now the CDF is something like this, fx of x equal to 0 for x less than a, it is x minus a by b minus a, if it is between a and b, 1 if x is greater than b. Is it okay? Now if you draw this, it would be something like this. Now it is 0 up to a, and from a to b it is a straight line, after that it is something like this. Now this is a, now this is b, this is 1, and what is this? X minus a by b minus a. This is your CDF of what random variable? Uniform random variable. So let me go back here. Now this is the CDF of uniform random variable. Okay. Now just now I told you some of the properties of a CDF. What are they? It is continuously varying form. Next, it is non-decreasing form, and it is a continuous in nature. No discontinuities. Here it has got no discontinuities, and it is non-decreasing function. Why? Because here it is 0 and it is increasing here, but after this it is constant. Okay, so we cannot say that it is increasing function, because it is not increasing always. It is increasing sometimes. Sometimes it remains constant here. So that's why we cannot say that these functions are increasing functions. But only thing is, they don't decrease. Either they increase or they remain constant, but they don't decrease. So that's why they are called non-decreasing functions. What they are called? Non-decreasing functions. Here, so this is something about area. Suppose we are finding at this point C. This is the area. You find out at this point. You find out entire area. Okay. So that's why while calculating CDF, don't calculate using overall area. Go by point by point. Suppose if x is less than a, what happens? If x is between a and b, what happens? If x is more than b, what happens? That is nothing but CDF. So generally students do mistake by calculating area or total area. Obviously you will get 1. Why? Because it is a property of normalization. Right. So next. Yeah. So this is question. A random variable x has a PDF as follows. Fx of x equal to x by 4. If it is from 1 to 3, 0 elsewhere, find its CDF. Okay, x by 4 from 1 to 3. Right. So let us go with this. Now here they are saying the PDF is something like this. Okay, I forgot to tell you one more thing. What is this here is now. Actually, what is the CDF? Integration of PDF. What is the PDF? Differentiation of CDF. Okay, you differentiate this CDF. What do you get? You get PDF. Isn't it? You do one thing. So do differentiation of this. What do you get? So up to b less than a, 0. Okay, what will happen if you do differentiation? So here 0. Next, this is a straight line. If you do differentiation, what do you get? Suppose what is differentiation of x? 1. In the same way, what is the differentiation of x minus a by b minus a, where a and b are constants? That is 1 by b minus a. A to b, 1 by b minus a. Now after b, it is 1, constant. What is the differentiation? 0. Okay? So if you have PDF, by integration you can get CDF. By differentiating CDF, you can get PDF. Okay? So they are two-way process. If you know one thing, you can find out remaining thing, or vice versa. If you know PDF, you can get CDF and vice versa. Okay. Okay. Now the given problem is x by 4 if it is between 1 and 3, correct? 0 elsewhere. Now, how to find out? Find out the CDF. What do you do? What does CDF means? So, minus infinity to x, fx of t dt. Okay. Now, what is fx of t? T by 4. 1 less than t less than 3. Is it okay? So let me draw that first of all, otherwise. What is the PDF graph? This is 1. This is 3, correct? This is fx of t, let us take. What is the value? What is this function? T by 4. Then what do you do? So less than 1, if t is less than 1, what will happen? It is 0. Okay. Then what do you do now? What do you do now? So take a point, midpoint here. Suppose it is somewhere here. X is somewhere here. Then what happens now? Integration from where to where? 1 to x. Integration from 1 to x. T by 4 dt. What it becomes? So integration of t by 4 is t square by, what will happen? T square by 8, limits are from 1 to x. Now what will happen now? This is x square minus 1 by 8. So I am not writing each and every thing here. If x lies here, the answer would be 0. If x lies here, you get the answer. If x is more than 3, obviously the answer should be 1. Now finally, what you can write is, it's fx of x equal to 0 if x is less than 1, it is x square minus 1 by 8 if it is between 1 and 3. 1 if it is more than 3. So if you do differentiation of this, what do you get? Do differentiation of this. Differentiate this. What will happen? Differentiation of this is what? 2x by 8. That is x by 4. What do you got? You got the again PDF back. Now this another problem, you do one thing, you solve this as homework. Now, so I'm explaining this CDF one more time for the sake of clarity. And now I'm explaining both at a time, continuous as well as discrete. Now, so fx of x equal to probability that x is less than equal to x. Now, if it is discrete, we use summation. If it is continuous, we use integration. Yeah, this is what cumulative means. So here one of the properties, it is non-decreasing means, this is also very very important. If x is less than or equal to y, obviously the corresponding CDFs also obeys the same law. If x is less than or equal to y, the corresponding CDFs also obeys the same law. Yeah. So here, when x tends to minus infinity, this will be tending to 0. When x is tending to infinity, it tends to 1. Okay, just now we have seen this here. Here, you can see. So, when x is tending to minus infinity, it is 0. When x is becomes infinity, it is 1. Yeah, I told you just now also, if it is discrete, it has a piecewise constant staircase like structure or form. It has got discontinuities. If the random variable is discrete, its CDF will be discontinuous, having staircase like form, and it is also called as piecewise constant CDF. Whereas if x is continuous, its CDF is also continuous. It doesn't have any discontinuities. Okay. Yeah. So here we'll see what is the mean and variance of a continuous random variable. Before proceeding, let me recall the mean and variance of a discrete random variable. What do we written? If x is a discrete random variable, what is the formula of mean? Expectation of x would be equal to summation over x, x into px of x. Now, what would you expect the formula of this expectation or mean if x happened to be a continuous random variable? Okay, before that, let me write, this is a PMF. What would happen? Can you guess? Expectation of x would be equal to, what will happen? Summation becomes what? Integration. X into PMF becomes PDF. That's it. Okay, sorry, here I had a mistake. So here minus infinity, it is summation over x, it is summation over all values of x.